Alright guys, this is part 3 of my Tag Match Ghillie. So, first few steps I will explain now. First step is to get your feet floating, flat, flat, so you can try and get out of your feet. Then you grab your netty, right across the top. Cut it to about the same size, so you're going to cut wide for that, and probably just across the bottom. Once you've done that, you want to grab a netting and stretch it, because mine is pretty elastic as you can stretch it a bit. You want to pull it around the top, the bottom of the side here. You want to leave it here, and here clean, old, not blue. So when you cut it later on, you can wrap this part, under part here, around the other side of the arm, so you'll have a full arm. As you can see, I've cut out all the excess around the edges and stuff. Make it look a bit neater, because you can leave it, but they just make it look a bit neater. As you can see as well, I've left flats under each arm. They're, like I said, to wrap around under each arm. The right one's probably a little bit small, but it doesn't matter that much because once you put the burlap sheeting on, your burlap sheet, or strip, sorry, it will usually cover and take down a fair bit, so it should be alright, even though there might be gaps, it will be fine. So the next stage is just to wrap them up, sew or glue them on. Once you've done that, pretty much, you just start, you cut your burlap strips, and start tying them on. So I'll show you the next stage.
The next part is cutting your burlap or your hessian bags, whatever. As you can see, I've got a really long strip. So what you do is basically, when you've got your sheet, you lay it flat and cut it from here, and you cut it the width of how wide you or how long you want your strips. Basically, then the next thing you do, you get your scissors, and good quality pair of scissors that cut, and basically cut them into strips like that. And you keep repeating this process. It's a pretty lengthy process. Sometimes it takes a while, so until you get strips like this. As you can see, there's purple bit, so take that out. It's quite easy, just grab the end and basically pull. And then, as you can see now, that's out. Alright, so basically you just keep repeating that till you've got lots of these, okay? Alright, the next step is tying your strips onto your netting, alright? So, as you can see, it's actually just the netting. This would be actually already attached to your shirt, pant or hat, depending on what part you're making. All you need to do, fold it in half, the burlap, like that, nice and thin. Just pop it through when it's on the uniform, slide it through the other side like that. You basically slide it till it's halfway through. And it's a lot easier actually on the clothes. And basically you tie a knot in the burlap. And as you can see now, that's completely attached to that, so that's not going to come off unless you cut it off. So basically you do that and you space them out, so you give it a couple bits of spacing, and you tie another one, just say for example there, and that starts to give you the effect of actually making a ghillie suit. So I've actually finished my ghillie suit, so when it comes to the next stage, you'll be able to just see the finished product. So basically you just keep repeating that on the back of the ghillie suit, and once you've filled up all the netting, you've pretty much finished the ghillie suit. Alright. Okay guys, so this is a final product. From your angle you can't really see much, but if I'll pick it up in a second, and I'll try and show you that there are some big gaps in the back, but it doesn't matter, because when you're actually trying to be camouflaged, you put some natural camouflage in there, and like blend it in with this, and it will help the effect of camouflaging, so you'll be a lot better and harder to spot. So
I have a quick look up the top. You can see that, yeah, you can see some green, but when you're actually laying down in the suit, it shouldn't be too bad. So as I said earlier, see, there's the arm. Yeah, you can just wrap it under and basically glue it to the other side, but I haven't done that yet because I haven't been bothered and I haven't had the hot glue gun with me. So basically, yeah, this is a finished product. So yeah, when you're tying them on, just make sure you tie them, leave a little bit of gap, tie it on, and just try and work from the bottom up or the top down, something like that, because when you just do patches, you kind of get annoyed. So the best way to do it is starting from the bottom and working your way up, and then just pulling the belt up down, because otherwise it just gets in your way. So that's basically it. So the next video I'll make, I'll actually test it, and yeah, we're going from there, alright? So good luck with that.